Yeah. you'd have met her, you'd have understood how much God forgave her for. We get lost in His forgiveness sometimes. We get lost in the fact that, oh boy, He forgave me for that so long ago that I don't have to still thank Him for it. I was a wretched sinner. I lied. I stole. I did whatever sinners do. I've been living for God now for about 30 years. And guess what? I'm still a sinner. And God still saves me. Prayed and I thanked Him, and you know, I don't care what you think of me anymore. It doesn't matter. All I care about is what God thinks. But I prayed, Brother Stewart, this past week. I've been praying, God, give me eyes to see my family saved. So I'm not begging You anymore because You promised it. But give me eyes to see them saved.
Yes, amen.
Hallelujah. God spoke to me week before we went to camp. I was praying, and I know it was God. I know without a shadow of a doubt it was God. I tried to tell or explain to Brother Stewart, and I couldn't get the words out of the table the other day because I was crying, because I knew, I already knew, I didn't really have to have God tell me. I said, well, I know that God wants me to do something. You think I should talk to my husband first because it concerns him? Well, yes. But he's going to say okay. He's not going to say no. Talk to me. I got home yesterday evening. We unloaded my car. And I sat in my chair and I said, James, I got to tell you something. I got to ask you something. He said, yeah. I said, James, I feel like the Lord spoke to me, sitting in this chair a week or so ago, and said, you want to be a good steward? You want to see things change in your life? Pay your tithes. Now I pay my tithes on my money, but I don't pay tithes on His. I knew what the Lord was saying. So I said, James, I feel like the Lord wants me to pay tithes on everything that comes in this house.
He said, yes, but if we don't apply what we've heard to our
I know I'm wasting your time, but I feel the presence of God in this place. I believe someone spoke to me in our dorm when we stayed in. She said, Jen, I'm going to tell you now, y'all better get ready, because God is fixing to do something great in Watson. We've heard that before, huh? This time I believe it. This time I know it's going to happen. She said, you, my friend, better make sure your feet are planted firm on the ground and you're ready to run when it happens, because it's going to be there and forward from there on. Stupid me said, well, Lord, I sure hope you give us some people that really want to work. It doesn't matter. I don't care. Whether you do or you don't, I want it, God. I want it more than anything. I almost feel like Rachel. Give me children.
Yeah. for the old rugged cross. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. You know, there's a portion of that song that says that one day we'll, our treasures at last. And I think about that, Sister Lou. How many treasures am I going to be able to lay down? We're not going to have many treasures if we keep church inside the four walls. We're not going to have many treasures if we don't tell our neighbors and our community that there's a safe